Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
It is often said of the Labrador Retriever that they are children covered in fur. I 100% agree with that sentiment. This is Zeke, this is Dogumentary TV, and this is the YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys have not already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. In this video, I will be giving my brief breed review of the Labrador Retriever. The Labrador Retriever originated in Newfoundland, Canada. At the time of its origination, the breed was used by fishermen. The dogs would jump into icy water and bring back fish that had fallen off the hook. So with that being the original working purpose of the breed, that gives you insight into the major characteristics of the breed. One, Labradors are a retriever, and two, Labradors love water. With trade being so prevalent between Canada and England, the breed became very popular in England as well. In 1830, a British sportsman named Colonel Hawker described the dogs as best for any kind of shooting, generally black and no bigger than a pointer, very fine in legs with short, smooth hair, is extremely quick running, swimming, and fighting. Today, the Labrador Retriever is one of the more popular dog breeds around the world. In fact, in the United States, it is the most popular dog breed and has been for some time. The reasons for this breed's popularity go beyond its wonderful looks, its cool aesthetics. This dog is, without a doubt, the Swiss Army knife of the canine world. Labradors are a very versatile and well-rounded dog breed. Their intelligence and desire to work allow them to excel at a variety of tasks. Obviously, they are excellent retrievers for hunters. They also perform very well as seeing eye dogs for the blind. And according to tacticalpolicetraining.com, Labradors make excellent detection dogs. They say, the perfect detection dog prospect is a dog that has a desire to hunt and retrieve an object. When testing a detection dog candidate, the trainers will gauge just how long and how hard the dog is willing to hunt for an object using just its nose. As a result of its genetic predisposition to hunt and to locate game for the hunter in most extreme climates without giving up, it is not uncommon for a Labrador Retriever to pass the detection dog selection criteria with flying colors. As for my personal opinion of the Labrador Retriever, I've been a fan of this breed since my early childhood, dating back to watching the movie Old Yeller. Now, I don't believe technically that the dog Old Yeller is a Labrador Retriever. I believe he's some sort of mix, or maybe a cur dog, but at the time, I didn't know dogs like I know dogs now, and had always assumed that he was just a Labrador Retriever. So I grew up for most of my life being a big fan of the Labrador Retriever. They were very prevalent in my neighborhood. All the dogs in my neighborhood that I came in contact with that were Labrador Retrievers were great dogs. They were fun dogs. They played with us as kids. We always could, you know, throw a ball and they would bring it back to us. They would run with us. They would, you know, we could ride our bikes. They were always great companions. So I've been a fan of the Labrador Retriever since very early on in my life. As I've gotten older and I've decided that I wanted other things for myself, I kind of moved away from the breed. But I feel like the Labrador Retriever is the dog that, if you don't know anything about dogs, but you want a dog, it's the dog that you should start with. They're very loving. They shouldn't have aggression issues. They're not a very aggressive dog breed. Now, they can be protective and they can bite. They do have teeth. All dogs can bite. So what should you take into consideration before buying a Labrador Retriever? Not much in terms of your life. And, you know, there's not a whole lot to take into consideration other than the fact that you're getting a dog. And the things that you take into consideration anytime you get any dog. So that is one, do you have the time to provide the dog with the proper amount of exercise? Physical and mental. You know, like I said, Labrador Retrievers are very well-behaved dogs, but every dog should be obedience trained, so you should have the time to put in the work to obedience train your dog. Socialize your dog. Also understand that your dog will need a certain amount of activity that probably will require to go outdoors. So along with long walks, you might want to, you know, it's a retriever, so, you know, playing fetch with a Labrador Retriever is ideal. If you have the time or the resources to get out into the wilderness or hiking trails, Labradors love that. They love to be outdoors. They are hunting dogs after all. If you can go out and hunt, if you can join the AKC and maybe even do some hunt training or hunting competitions, which Labradors would love that. Labradors are a working dog. So anything that you can do when you get a dog to satisfy its genetics, it's always a great thing to do. Labradors are a generally healthy breed, so you know you don't have to get too much into worrying about health. Obviously, you want to find a breeder who's health testing. Obviously, issues like hip and elbow dysplasia are prevalent amongst all dog breeds. There are some other things that can be issues for the breed, but just make sure that you got whoever you're buying your dog from has taken care to test the parents so that those ailments will not be as prevalent or as likely in the puppy. Other than that, you know, like I said, I'm a full go on anybody wanting to buy a Labrador Retriever. Just be prepared to, you know, spend the time, dedicate the time to exercise, obedience train, and socialize your dog. These dogs are for everybody. Anybody that loves dogs or wants a dog, a Labrador Retriever is a great place to start. All right, this is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV. Peace. Your own style, that's just slang for you, ain't got it.